So good morning. Sorry, Batavis is coming. We see an ironic thing when Sorry, Batavis is no matter what happens, any day of the week we fast. And the reason for that is the beginning of everything. But in general, what is a fast? A fast is one of the ways to do tshuva. So what does fasting do? What does really fasting do? So fasting takes away our physical desires. And that's why we fast. Because we draw down godliness to the lowest levels. We draw down godliness to our every limb of our body. We don't just leave it by spiritual things. We don't just leave it by theoretical things. But the tshuva has to come into every aspect of our lives. And that's the uniqueness of Asara B'Tavis. Asara B'Tavis, no matter what happens, we fast is because it is the harshest fast, because if they would have done tshuva at that point, it would have been over. We wouldn't have any Churban Beis HaMikdash. We wouldn't have the continuation. So that is the lowest situation which we can be. That we had the chance to do tshuva and we didn't. And that's the idea of Asara B'Tavis. Asara B'Tavis reveals the essence of every Jew. And the right reason why, because it says, Ba'etzem Ayem Hazeh. With the inner part of the actual day. Asara B'Tavis. And we know that just like Yom Kippur was Ba'etzem Ayem Hazeh, that is on the 10th day of the month of Tishrei. Asara B'Tavis is on the 10th day in the 10th month. So it has a very big koyach that we can actually transform this tainus to a day of simcha and joy with the coming of Mashiach. And then automatically all the days are days of joy and everything else. So we can't take this fast lightly as a regular other fast. This fast has the capability of bringing joy to Klal Yisrael. This fast is going to give us koyach. That we should be able to go towards Mashiach. And that is the whole purpose of this fast. Is to be turned over to days of joy. And then you'll have oneg from it. You'll have pleasure from it. Knowing that we're going to go towards the Gula. So let's not jump the bandwagon. Let's tell Hashem we want Mashiach now. Let's rectify ourselves. Not only theoretically, but down to eating. Which the neshama also gets sustenance from our food. The neshama gets sustenance from our food because there are sparks of Kedusha which is in the food. Nevertheless, we don't eat. So the Eibishter should help that Asarei Teves should be Asiri Sheba Asiri. Like it says, Asiri Yer Kodesh, that the 10th one becomes holy, the 10th animal, when you take mice of animals. Let's not use out the day of Asarei Teves in a physical way, in a material way, but to do tshuva to the fullest extent. So Be'ez Hashem, this Asarei B'Teves will be Asiri Sheva Asiri, the idea of Holy of Holies, the third Beis HaMikdash, in the fullest extent. So the Eibishter should help that we should get rid of it already. Because this is the focal point of Asarei B'Teves. Asarei B'Teves was that if you do tshuva, there's no churba. No churba means the gula amitis v'ashleima. So let's have it immediately right now. But don't kid yourself and do other things and say, I did tshuva. So the Eibishter should help that we should fulfill our job of Asarei B'Teves and go to the Gula Amitis V'Ashleima. When then the Asarei B'Teves will, all the Yom Tevim, for sure Asarei B'Teves will be transformed to days of joy and happiness of Yom Tevim V'Smechim. Long live a master, teacher, and ever, King Mashiach forever and ever. Long live a master, teacher, and ever, King Mashiach forever and ever. Long live a master, teacher, and ever, King Mashiach forever and ever.